His second sum is the vector field F bar. That vector field is denoted by F bar. X square minus y square plus x I minus 2xy plus yj irrotational. If so, find its scalar potential. So for irrotational field, we have to start from del cross F bar. Del cross F bar is curl of F bar, and it is evaluated using determinant. In determinant, first row and second row is common, and third row is coming from given field. This coefficient of I have to write here. First element, coefficient of j, second element. Okay, this minus sign I have distributed on the inner part of the bracket, and k is not there. Coefficient of k is 0. Now try to solve this determinant. I leave this row and this column. I multiplied by its minor. Minor means what? Leave this row and column. Del del y of 0 is 0. Minus del del z of this. See, derivative with respect to z, keeping x and y constant. Derivative with respect to z, keeping x and y constant. Is here z is not there, means this is constant. Derivative of constant is 0. J, second element. While solving determinant, we have to put here minus sign by default. Now the minor of j, leave this column and row. Del del x of 0 is 0, and del del z of this. Derivative of this with respect to z, keeping x and y constant, means x and y are constant term, there is no z. The derivative of constant term will be 0 with respect to z. K, and minor of k, leave this column and row. Del del x of this element, but derivative with respect to x, keeping x, y and z constant. Derivative of x is 1 minus 2y, and derivative of this term minus y is 0 with respect to x. Minus derivative of this term with respect to y, keeping x z constant. Derivative of x square is constant because this is only the term in x. Derivative of y square is 2y with negative sign, and derivative of x with respect to y is 0. No need to write. Means this is 0i, 0j, this will get cancelled, 0k. Del cross F bar is a 0 vector. This implies F bar is irrotational. We have to find out associated scalar potential. So there are different ways to find scalar potential associated with the vector field which are irrotational. Here, find the scalar potential. So we are going to find out the scalar potential. Let F bar is equal to gradient of phi. F bar is equal to gradient of phi. Yes, many times when the scalar potential is required, this relation is also given, because in modeling, if the direction is opposite direction, in that case F bar is equal to minus of gradient of phi is given. But if it is not provided, then you start from it. F bar is equal to gradient of phi. The F bar is given, and phi is associated scalar potential we have to find. Means value of phi we have to find, F bar is given. Value of phi we have to find, F bar is given. So F bar is equal to this value of F bar. I am writing x square minus y square plus x I minus 2xy plus y j plus 0k. 0k, no need to write. And gradient of phi is I del phi by del x. You can call it, this is a formula for gradient of phi. Formula for gradient of phi: I del phi by del x plus j del phi by del y plus k del phi by del z. F bar is given, and by formula gradient of phi is the same. Now I am equating coefficients of I, j, k. Okay, if you equate coefficient of I, what will you get? X square minus y square plus x is equal to del phi by del x. Del phi by del y is coefficient of j, is minus 2xy minus y. This minus sign I am taking inside of the bracket. and del phi by del z, coefficient of k is coefficient of k. Yes, we have equated coefficients of I, j, k, and three differential equation we have obtained. This is del phi by del x, del phi by del y, del phi by del z. I want value of phi. So what I am going to do? I am going to integrate with respect to x, because from del phi by del x, how do you get phi? By integration. Integrate with respect to x, keeping y and z constant. Here, integrate with respect to y, keeping integrate with respect to y, keeping x and z constant. In the last case, integrate with respect to z, keeping x and y constant. This del phi by del x, del phi by del y, del phi by z, del z. We are integrating this with respect to x, keeping y z constant. Integrate with respect to y, keeping x z constant. Integrate with respect to z, keeping x y constant. Now, I am not putting here integration sign, writing directly. The integration of derivative of phi is phi. Directly writing with respect to x. Integration of x square is x cube by 3 with respect to x. We are integrating with respect to x. This y is constant. Integration of constant term is what? Constant multiplied by variable. Y square is constant and integration of constant is constant multiplied by variable because we are integrating with respect to x. Integrate with respect to x. Integration of x is x square by 2. Now integration constant I am putting. The integration constant I am putting psi 1 of, we are treating y and z constant, psi 1 of yz I am putting, integration constant. Because we are treating yz constant, the function of yz will be integration constant. In that way I have written. Then again here, integration of derivative of phi is phi, but here we are integrating with respect to y, keeping xz constant. See, 2x is constant, minus 2x is constant, and integration of y is y square by 2. This 2 you can cancel. Integration of y is what? With respect to y is y square by 2. And now integration of these two terms we have taken. Integration constant is function of xz. Because phi we have used for a scalar point function, that's why I am using psi 1, psi 2, psi 3. You can use a small f1, small f2, small f3 also. Now integrate with respect to z, phi is equal to integration of 0 is 0 plus integration constant is what? Psi 3 xy. Once again, f bar and gradient of phi. By formula, gradient of phi is this. F bar is given. You may be given different f bar in the examination. Equate coefficients of I, j, k. Equating coefficient of I, this equation you are getting. Equating coefficient of j, this equation, and equating coefficient of k, this equation. Now, first equation. Integrate with respect to x, keeping yz constant. When you are keeping yz constant, put integration constant as a function of yz. Here, integration with respect to y, keep integration constant a function of xz. Integration constant function of xy, like. Now, we are interested in scalar potential. What we are going to do? We have to solve these three equations, equation 1, equation 2, and equation 3, and finding values of psi 1, psi 2, psi 3. Now, after finding values of psi 1, psi 2, psi 3, putting values of psi 1, psi 2, psi 3 there, you will be getting value of phi. Now, in short, I am going to find value of psi 1, psi 2, psi 3 and writing solution directly. Solving 1, 2 and 3. What we get here? Phi is equal to solving these three equations and finding value of psi 1, psi 2, psi 3. So directly I am writing. Yes, finding value of psi 1, psi 2, psi 3 and getting value of phi in this single step. The shortcut way I tell you. Here, other than constant, how many common terms are there? See, minus xy square and minus xy square are the common terms. These two terms are common terms. So write down common term here, single time.
common term I have written. Is there common term again? No, there is no common term in these three equations other than constants. Common term I have written at once. Now write down all uncommon terms. See, this term is uncommon. I am writing here plus x cube by 3. This term is uncommon, x square by 2. This term is common that we have covered. This term is uncommon, is minus y square by 2. What we have done? We have written common and uncommon terms. Common terms, single time, and uncommon term, we have to write there. So what we have done in the single step, we have calculated value of psi 1, psi 2, psi 3 and found value of phi directly. So this is the scalar potential. This is the scalar potential and no need to find out value of psi 1, psi 2, psi 3. But if you are interested to find out value of psi 1, what will be the value of psi 1 here? See, this is common and x square by 2 is minus y square by 2 will be the value of psi 1 y z. What is the value of psi 2 xz? Means x cube by 3. X cube by 3 means this is a common term and minus y square by 2 means x cube by 3 and x square by 2. This will be psi 2 xz. Psi 3 xz will be all these three. Psi 3 xz. But no need to find out value of this three. Just you write down common and uncommon terms. That's all. So what we have done here, we found scalar potential associated with this vector field. Now, quickly, the next problem show that the vector field f bar y e to the power xy into cos z I plus x e to the power xy cos z j minus e to the power xy sin z k. And what is the question? Show that fr is irrotational. Also find scalar potential such that the relation is given such that fr is equal to gradient of pi. Okay, same thing. Everything is same. Only fr is changed. First of all, I'll show it is irrotational. Yes, for irrotational, del cross fr I have to calculate. Del cross fr, how you are going to calculate? Determinant, first row is same always when you take del cross f bar or curl of f bar. Second row is also same always and third row is a coefficients of ijk from given vector field. Means first element y e to the power xy into cos z, x e to the power xy into cos z minus e to the power xy into sin z. Solve this determinant and you will be getting 0. This determinant I am not going to solve now because much more time will be wasted. In previous lecture and in this lecture also, in second sum, we have evaluated determinant. Now this part I am leaving up to you to solve the determinant. Del cross f bar directly I have written 0. And this implies f bar is irrotational. Now next part is the scalar potential we have to find. What is given to you? If it is not given, then you have to let f bar is gradient of phi. Now value of f bar is given y e to the power x y cos z phi x e to the power x y cos z j minus e to the power xy sin z k. This is f bar. Gradient of phi is what by formula? I del phi by del x, j del phi by del y and k del phi by del y. Only f bar is changed, rest of the things. Now equating coefficients of I, j, k, del phi by del x, therefore del phi by del x is coefficient of I, del phi by del y is coefficient of j and del phi by del z is coefficient of k. See, integrate with respect to x, keeping y and z constant. Here I'll integrate with respect to y, keeping x z constant.
and in third equation, differential equation, integrate with respect to z, keeping x, y constant. Integrate with respect to x, with respect to y, with respect to z. Now, integration of del phi by del x with respect to x is phi. Integration of this term with respect to x, keeping y, z constant. See, y and z constant, y is constant, cos z is multiplicative constant. Integration of exponential term as it is, because x is present. When you take integration of any function, I am taking integration with respect to x. The coefficient of x, I have to write in the denominator. Or, you can say the derivative of xy, keeping x variable and other constants in the denominator, plus integration constant. Integration constant is psi 1 of yz. Now, integration of del phi by del y with respect to y is phi again. Integration of this with respect to y, x is constant, cos z is constant, see, x and z constant. Integration of e to the power xy is e to the power xy. And coefficient of y, we are getting y variable, right? In the denominator, I have to write. Plus integration constant psi 2 of xz. Integration of this with respect to z. Integration of this with respect to z now. Keeping x and y constant. See, here minus sign is as it is. E to the power xy is constant. We are keeping x and y constant. And integration of sin z is what? Minus cos z with respect to z. Plus integration constant psi 3 of xy. Very simple. Integration with respect to x, integration with respect to y, integration with respect to z, keeping other variable constant. Now solving equation 1, 2, 3, we get phi is equal to, write common and uncommon terms. See, common term is what? Cos z e to the power xy, cos z e to the power xy, and cos z e to the power xy. These three terms are same. Common term I have written. What is the common term? Cos z e to the power xy. And uncommon term, there is no uncommon term, because single term is present other than a constant, and all these terms are common. So this common term I have written at once. So this is the scalar potential. And what will be value of psi 1, psi 2, psi 3? Psi 1, psi 2, psi 3 will be 0. Is it? So this is scalar potential we have calculated associated with FR. Now next, if F1 bar is given to you, y plus zi, z plus xj, and x plus yk, this vector field is given. And another vector field is given, F2 bar is x square minus yz I, y square minus xz j, and z square minus xy k. Here two vector fields are given. So what is the question? If this is there, then show that del dot F1 bar cross F2 bar is equal to 0. Then you can do like this also. First of all, you find F1 bar cross F2 bar, and then take the del dot of it, means divergence of it. Del dot means divergence. Or, in order to minimize the efforts, this del dot F1, F2, del dot F1 cross F2 is what? It is, here I am writing, A bar, B bar, and C bar. Okay, in preliminaries we have discussed this. Three vectors are given and dot cross is there. So what is it? It is scalar triple product. And this scalar triple product of three vectors can be arranged in this way. As if you start from B bar, after B bar C is there, and after C A is there. The meaning of these two is same. these two scalar triple products are same. Now this same scalar triple product can be written, but which starts from C1, C, after C A is there, and after A B is there, then dot cross. So all these three scalar triple products are same. So using this concept, then we can write this A B C. The del is a vector, you don't forget. The del is what I del del X plus J del del Y plus K del del Z. This is the vector differential operator del. This is vector, this is vector, this is vector. And this can be written as, that is to show, I am starting from F1, F1, after F1, F2, and after F2 del. And here, F1, F2 del, F1, after F1, F2, after F2 del, and dot cross will do it. You can write this scalar triple product starting from F2 also. It is your choice. Now, if meaning of this two same, either you solve, prove this is equal to 0 or this is equal to 0, carries the same meaning. But here, F1 cross F2 means the determinant of these two, means F1 cross F2, how do you calculate? See, and how do you get the cross of any two? Cross of any two vectors, the ijk is common always. F1, its coefficients of ijk, y plus z, z plus x, x plus y, then x square minus yz here, from F2 now, y square minus xz, and z square minus xy. See, if you try to find out cross of this two, so this determinant you have to evaluate. Okay, that will be the wastage of time. So instead of doing that, in that way you can do, but in order to minimize the time of solution, so this can be written as like this using these properties of the scalar triple product. And what I am going to do, del cross F2, del, this is bar, you know, whenever vector is there, that is denoted by bar, but not necessarily. Del cross F2 I am going to find. So I am going to consider del cross F2, F2 cross del and del cross F2, okay. Means here A bar cross B bar, in preliminaries we have seen, it is minus of B bar cross A. So I am going to find out del cross F2. The del cross F2, how do you calculate? IJK. When you find out curl of F2 or del cross of F2, first two rows are same. And coefficient of IJK from F2, x square minus yz, y square minus xz, and z square minus xy. This is equal to, I write down minor of I now. Leave this row, column and row, del del y of this is minus x, minus del del z of this is minus x again, writing directly, because sufficient practice we have done on solving determinant. Minor of j now, leave this column of j and row of j, del del x of this is minus y, del del z of this is what, minus y again, plus k. Leave this column and row, del del x of this is minus z, del del y of this is what, minus z, is it? Now, this all x, plus minus y and plus minus z gets cancelled and we are getting 0. Here, del cross F2 is 0, therefore F2 cross del will be 0.